From the very beginning, counting cases was the way to go with COVID. It's how we all made sense, or tried to make sense, out of what was going on. There was a sense of comfort in those basic numbers. The higher they were, the more COVID we thought there was. But
it paints a picture, but probably not the whole picture.
Dr. Deepti Pandita is the Chief Health Information Officer at Hennepin Healthcare. She says in the beginning, case numbers were pretty accurate. There were only a few places you could get tested, but with more options like at-home tests, she says a lot of cases never get counted.
You have to also factor in the availability of tests.
At some points during the pandemic, you could get tested anywhere you'd like. At other points, tests were hard to find. Plus, Pandita says the virus we're dealing with right now is not the same virus we were dealing with nearly 2 years ago.
I mean, we know that Omicron is more spreadable, spreads more rapidly, but not as virulent in the sense that it doesn't cause as severe disease. So yes, you're not comparing apples to apples.
So if not case numbers, is there a better way to track this virus?
Hospitalizations are a good marker for us to follow.
Dr. Mark Sanis at Health Partners feels hospitalization rates, positivity rates, and the number of filled up ICU beds may be better numbers to keep track of during this Omicron spike.
There isn't a sort of gray area. If someone needs oxygen and needs to be hospitalized, that's an easier way to count than trying to figure out, all right, how many people have COVID in the community with this variation in the testing that we've seen. So if you're sick enough to require hospitalization, that's an easier metric to count over time, and it's more of a constant. That hasn't changed much throughout the pandemic. And I think that's our best indicator right now for the burden of infection.
So looking at those numbers, where are we at right now?
I think we are seeing numbers in our hospitals that would suggest we're seeing more people with a little bit milder illness over these last 7 to 10 days. With, you know, Cross Health Partners, we're probably up 50 patients in our medical surgical units with COVID, but the numbers in our ICUs have not gone up appreciably.
Not yet, but Santa says more ICU beds could fill up before this latest wave runs its course. He says it's still important for people to take this virus seriously, to maintain social distance for the time being, and if you do feel sick or had an exposure, it's still important to get tested.
I don't think we can assume yet that this is going to be a milder surge when it comes to hospitalizations and intensive care unit stays for our people that get infected. And we'll get through this. We have another month to go probably, but we will get through this.
Doctors say the latest models show we could reach the peak within 7 to 10 days, but some models show we might not reach it until February. Good news is, after the peak, we could see a quick drop in cases. That's what some other countries have seen, but, you know, there's always the chance we could see something different.